So let's continue to look at the labor supply side of things. So in this model with unemployment insurance, so we've introduced the utility function for workers, consumption utility, which is concave to describe risk aversion. So we set the disutility from job search, psi of E, it's going to be increasing and convex. So just to simplify a bit, we are going to specify, the disutility from job search. So we'll assume that we have a quadratic disutility. You know, it's a little bit like when you work with a Cobb-Douglas matching function by specifying the functional form, you can simplify the analysis quite a bit. So here we'll assume quadratic disutility. So that means it means that psi of E is going to be E squared divided by 2. Okay, so we're going to use that. Okay, so this is just a quadratic function, so it is increasing, it is convex, it satisfies our assumption, but choosing it quadratic will simplify things a lot, because as you can imagine, once you take the derivative of psi of E, with that form, it just E. So it's going to help us a lot in the analysis. Okay, so we have all the setup for the representative workers. So now the question is, how do, here they have to make a decision, the workers. They have to decide how much to search. So how do they do that? So we're going to study the worker's problem and try to see, what is the problem that they're trying to solve and what is the type of decision they're going to come to. So the problem of the worker, of course, is to maximize utility in general. Here, it's going to be an expected utility. Why expected? Because there is some uncertainty. The worker is going to search for a job and he may end up being employed or he may end up being unemployed. So there's this uncertainty that's here. So we have to take an expected utility here. So we have to weight each of these possible outcomes. The worker is going to maximize utility. How? By choosing the appropriate amount of search effort. So formally, the worker's problem is to max by choosing the right amount of effort. So the expected utility. So what do we have? So if you're so in the baseline case in which the worker doesn't get a job, the utility, the consumption utility that you get is U of Cu. So this is the baseline case in which you're unlucky, you don't get a job. And then, what is the probability that you're actually lucky and get a job? It's the probability to find a job. That probability is E times F of theta, right? This is as we had said. Then what happens if you get your job? Well, you get a big bump in utility. Instead of having your consumption utility U of C U, you're going to get an increased consumption utility, and you're going to get to U of C E, the consumption level when you're employed. So here, we have to capture the fact that you bump up your utility when you get a job, so we're going to put delta U here. This is the increase in utility that you get only in the case in which you're lucky to have a job. Okay? So we have our baseline utility, U of Cu, the possible utility that you gain on top of that if you have a job, which is E F theta delta U. And then, of course, you have to subtract the disutility from searching. So that's minus the disutility of search, which is here E squared divided by 2, because we've assumed a quadratic disutility from search. Okay. All right. So how do we maximize this? Well, this is very simple. Once more, our objective function You know, it's you have a term that's linear, the e f of theta delta u. You subtract a term that's quadratic. So again, you have a function that's strictly concave. To find the maximum of a function that's strictly concave, you just need to take the first order condition and find the point where the derivative, find the point where the derivative is zero. So in general, these first order conditions are just necessary conditions. They capture an extremum. So it can be a maximum, a minimum. It doesn't have to be unique, but when your function is concave, you know that your first order condition gives you the unique maximum. Okay, so let's take the first order condition. We take the derivative. Of the objective function. So u of cu, the term that we have here, it's constant, so it disappears. E f of theta delta u, the derivative with respect to e is just going to be f of theta delta u, and then minus the derivative of e squared divided by 2, that's e, and that has to be equal to 0. So here it's very simple. What's the optimal effort here? E is just... Yes, optimal, maybe it's confusing. But the effort chosen by workers in order to maximize utility, it's E is equal to F of theta times delta U. Okay, and that amount of effort, we're going to call it an effort supply, right? Because that's the effort that the worker supply to the market. And as you can see, the effort supply, it's a function of theta. So when the labor market is in different conditions, the effort is going to change. Because as you can see here, theta enters f of theta, and of course, it's also a function of ui, of the generosity of ui, because we said the amount delta u, so gap in utility between people who are employed and unemployed, that's captured, that's determined by the generosity of ui. So we're going to say the effort depends also on ui. So we have our optimal effort here. Okay, so here we found that the effort of worker depends both on the tightness and on UI. So what's the logic? What's the intuition here? Well, it's pretty simple. So you can see when delta U becomes bigger, people search more. Okay, so that means that when UI becomes less generous, because you remember when UI is less generous, delta U is bigger. So when UI becomes less generous, people search more. What's the reason for that? Well, when UI becomes less generous, there is much more to gain by getting a job because you're not really covered when you're unemployed. And so, of course, that gives a big incentive for people to search. Okay, so that's one of the key intuition here. When UI drops, so it becomes less generous, that means that, gain from working is large. The gain from working goes up, of course, because if you're not covered when you're unemployed, you'll suffer a lot when you're unemployed, so people want to work. The gain from working goes up, and that's going to stimulate search. It means that you have your incentive to search goes up. Because now you have a lot to gain, and therefore your effort is going to go up. Okay? So in a sense, if UI, here the variable UI captures, you know, the generosity of UI, what we've just showed is that the partial derivative of the effort supply with respect to UI is negative. Okay, so when you have a more generous UI, you're going to reduce search effort. And here you can see it easily in this function because the partial derivative, you know, when UI goes up, you know what happens, that when UI goes up, delta U goes down, and of course ES is going to go down. The second thing that we see and this is kind of the key, one of the key effects that people talk about when they talk about the cost of unemployment insurance. And in fact, if you listen to the current debate surrounding the coronavirus recession and the extension of unemployment insurance, one thing that comes back now that the recovery has started is that people are worried that if you increase the generosity of UI a lot, people are not going to search for a job, and that's going to slow down the recovery. So that effect, the fact that effort is less when UI is more generous, is very present in the political discourse. And empirically, when you look at the data, it does seem to be present as well. At the, if you look at individual workers, when UI is more generous, they search less. The second thing we see is, of course, the job finding rate, F of theta. This is increasing in theta, as we've discussed many, many times. And therefore, the effort supply is going to be increasing in theta as well. Because when theta goes up, F of theta goes up, and therefore, effort supply goes up. So what's the intuition here? Well, when theta goes up, it means that for, you know, the return on each unit of effort is higher. Because for each unit of effort that you add, the probability, you know, that you're going to find a job based on that unit of effort goes up because F of theta is higher. So the return on effort goes up, and that means that if you have a higher return for a fixed cost, your incentive to search goes up. And as a result, your effort is going to go up. So that explains why we have this result that the partial derivative of effort with respect to tightness is positive. Okay, so basically, you know, your workers are trying to figure out they are trying to figure out what the return, what are the benefits from searching, and they know that when UI is more generous, there are less benefits, so they search less, and they know when the tightness is higher, there are more benefits, so they search more. So that's what's going to happen.